Hello guys, let us see how to populate our dropdown using MVC and SQL Server database. Here I am creating one employee details table and fields ID, name, job and their data types. And I have inserted some dummy data, employee names, their job. Let us jump to our Visual Studio and so let us create an application. Click on project, select ASP.NET Web Application, give name, drop, click on OK, select MVC, click on OK. We will create one data layer using class library so we can have layered architecture in our project. Let me add one layer for our data layer, for our data. Click on new project, select class library, name it data layer, click on OK. You can delete this class file, it is not important. So this is our application and this is layer for our data. So now let us create EDMX file. So we can manipulate our data. To create EDMX file, right click on your data project, click on add, click on new item, click on data and select Edu.NET entity data model and you can give name, click on add, click next. You can create new connection. Here we need to write our server name. To find server name, you can directly go to your studio and right click here and just copy this name. Then go to your Visual Studio, paste this name here. And you can see this drop down is highlighted now. And here you can select your database. Click on your database. Let me check. Yes. Our connection is succeeded. Click on OK. Here our connection string is created. This is our server name. This is our database name. Now click on next. Select your tables. Here I want only this employee details table. Click on finish. You can see EDMX file is created now. And here we need to copy our connection string from our newly created file to our web applications web config file. You can comment your old file, paste your new connection string. You should comment your old file. So now our application is pointing to this new connection string having our database employee DB. Click on save. Now let's jump to controller and create one controller. To create controller, right click on controllers, click on add, and here you can see controller. Click on that and select empty controller, click on add. Can give your controller name. Suppose give name DD controller. Click on add. This will create controller. Here this one index is default method in our controller. Now we need to create one entity model. Go to models, right click here, click on class, give name, click on add, write properties in our model. I will add some properties for our model. Properties into entity model, that is ID, name, surname, job, joining date, city and this date. Now let us go to our controller. Here I am writing one function to get list of employee details. Now let us create object of our DB entities. And create object of list. Return this result. Now take one variable, context dot or table name dot select. Lambda expression new dot. So here we are selecting whole table. And if you want to select some particular fields, the name, job or city, you can select it. And if you want to select all data, you just write new lambda expression dot to list. Here, in this way, we are getting all employee details into list and in this obj variable. So now let us get this data into a list. Write down if and our object dot count. In that case, write down one for each loop, for each data in OBJ. So now here create one object of our entity model equal to data dot entry name model dot kernel equal to data data dot kernel. For now we will take these three fields, but we can take all the fields that we are getting in our object. So let us pass this model into our list. So now we are getting all the employee details. Let's pass this function into our method, index method. Let me add employee ID into model. Now as we wanted to create drop down for name or job, so we need to create one model entity. Go to our model class. Here, write down public get here employee ID. Employee name, create one property here, with this so in this way we can create properties for other drop downs. Suppose let us create for job right, and create one property for job. So in this way you can create properties for your drop downs, like surname, whatever you want downs you can create. As of now we are done with this function, and we have passed this function here in index method, but we need to create object for entity model. And then model dot our list name dot down is equal to this method. Getting this message that cannot implicitly convert type of drop down view model to name drop down view. As you can see, we have created this new model. So let us copy this model and pass it to our method here. You can see now we are not getting this, that message, and this property, copy this name, see. Okay. Save this. We are passing this function result into our model, and in model we have created this property, and this property is basically a list of my employee ID and employee name. In this way we have created also one model job drop down, and in that we have got employee ID and employee job name. So let's create one function for that. Click copy this function, paste it here, and just replace this model entity name with this name. Take this job name, job. This is not right. Rename this method get job drop down. This method dot job drop down property is equal to this method. Return two functions. From here we can get employee name and employee job details, and we have passed those two functions into our index method in list properties that we have defined in our entity model. So now let us create view. Right click on index method, add view, and select entity. Don't use any layout. Now we have model drop down view model. You can select that model. So here this is our view for our index method, and we have passed this model into our view. So now let us write one drop down here. Now here we will take a razor code for each variable or data in model. Select this list name drop down property. Now here if you want to save your names into or save your drop down selected data, then you can have your ID each option. So in this way we have written one drop down for our employee name, as we are getting two drop downs, one is for job and one is for name. So let us copy this, paste it below, and employee job. Select that model and employee job name. Select job. So in this way we have written two drop downs for job and name. So now let us run our code. Because that see here we are passing these two functions result into our model, and model is having two list properties, in that we got respective models for job and name, and we are returning this model into our index method. And that index method is having view. In that view, we have to be getting two drop downs for name and job. So let us save this and run. Our controller name is PD and the method is index. So here you can see we got two drop downs, one is select name and another one is select job. Successfully fetched data for drop downs, you can see here. Thanks for watching.